begun on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom. Thank you. Apostle Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field. You are God's building. According to the grace of God, which was given to me by a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, and another builds on it. But let each one take heed how he builds on it. For no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now if anyone builds on this foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, straw, each one's work will become clear. For the day will declare it, because it will be revealed by fire, and the fire will test each one's work of what sort it is. If anyone's work which he has built on it endures, he will receive a reward. If anyone's work is burned, he will suffer loss, but he himself will be saved, yet so as through fire. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone defiles the temple of God, God will destroy him. For the temple of God is holy, which temple you are. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. And those who are Christ's have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking one another, envying one another. Brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness, considering yourself, lest you also be tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. And to your spirit, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Come, let us rejoice in the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to God our Savior. Before his face with thanksgiving, let us make a joyful noise to him with songs of praise.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commandments.
It is a ghost, they cried out in fear. Immediately Jesus stretched out his hand, took hold of Peter, and said, O you of little faith, why did you doubt? When they got up into the boat, the wind ceased. Those who were in the boat came forward and fell down and worshipped him, saying, You are truly the Son of God. When they had crossed over the lake, they arrived in the land of the Gennesaret. Jesus came down with them and stood on a level place. A number of his disciples and a great multitude of people from all Judea, Jerusalem, and the seacoast of Tyre and Sidon came to hear him and to be healed of their diseases. Those who were troubled by unclean spirits also came, and they were healed. The whole multitude desired to touch him because power came out of him and healed them. Jesus looked up at his disciples and said, Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who hunger now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when men shall hate you, and when they shall exclude you and mock you, and throw out your name as evil for the sake of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for behold, your reward is great in heaven, for your fathers did the same thing to the prophets.
Peace be unto you, who made thy eyes.
Let us say with all our souls.
us mankind, and to thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For the sick, the suffering of this disease, may the Lord God remember them in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. For those who have no one to pray for them, may the Lord God remember them in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. And you and all Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember you in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Christ,
let us ask.
We bring our most holy ghost
as harlot and suffered and was born.
Winged, many-eyed, who soar aloft, borne on their pinions. Singing the triumphant hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord of Sabaoth, heaven and earth are full of thy glory.
according to this reasonable and bloodless worship, and ask thee and pray thee and supplicate thee, send down the Holy Spirit upon us, and upon these gifts here offered.
This mystical bread.
And make this bread to be the precious body of thy Christ. Amen. And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of thy Christ, making the change by thy Holy Spirit. That they may be to those who partake for the vigilance of soul, for remission of sins, for the communion of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, for boldness towards thee, and not for judgment or condemnation. Again we offer unto thee this reasonable worship for those who fall asleep in the faith, ancestors, fathers, mothers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary.
Ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory in the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Gather with the holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you. Blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commandments.
The righteous shall be
sanctification. To thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Let us depart in peace. Bless those who bless thee and sanctify those who trust in thee. Save thy people and bless an inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them in return by the divine power and forsake us not to put our hope in thee. Give peace, thy will, to thy churches, to thy priests, to those in civil authority, and to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee do we send up glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Salvation, Christ our true God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, the holy, glorious, and laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, of the blessed Herman of Alaska, whose memory we keep this day, and the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and the lover of men, God.
Bishop of Washington, Metropolitan of all America and Canada, His Eminence the Most Reverend Polish Bishop of Chicago and the Midwest, this God protect and let its President and all civil authorities, the clergy and faithful of this holy temple and all Orthodox Christians, O Lord, preserve them for us.
Christ is in our midst. Please be seated for one moment. You know, we're celebrating this year the 50th anniversary of the Orthodox Church in America. And it is a fine achievement for us, all of those who are working in the vineyard of Christ here in the Orthodox Church in America. We're very blessed and pleased to have the saints among us that we have canonized here in this land, especially that of St. Herman of Alaska, one of the most beloved and well-known Orthodox saints. His glorification happened on this day, August 9th of 1907. So at that time, 50 years ago, began the Orthodox Church in America, so we are very thankful to that. Just think about it. All of those years ago, all the people in Alaska, on the Isle of Kodiak, celebrating this beautiful event together, making the pilgrimages there to the St. Herman's there and the church there. His relics now lay in state in the Resurrection Church there in Alaska, and Akathists are served there to this day every week. And of course his relics have been spread across the United States. I know we have relics in various different churches and monasteries in the United States, and we know that his life and his work was incredible amongst the Native American people there, the Athalaskans. He kept them safe. He went to battle for them many, many times. His stories are well known. A lot of his miracles. He's a wonder worker. He was seen singing with angels. He was witnessed to have cured, through his prayers, cured people. There was a moment where an icon was placed. A tsunami warning was made. An icon was placed of the Mother of God on the shores by St. Herman. He said, the waves will not go beyond this point, and they didn't. There were many, many, many numerous miracles that continue even up until today. In fact, my mother in 1970, just my own very mother, was having a lot of trouble bearing children. And in fact, was tested positive for cancer. And they said it was pretty much unlikely that you will have children. So in 1970, when our priest, Father John Pasinka, where I grew up in Campbell, Ohio, came back with an icon printed a prayer. He said to my mother, keep this icon, pray to this icon of this holy saint. And certainly enough, she prayed to it. The further testing showed no signs of cancer. And then there was my sister, and 14 months later was me. And then 6 years later, then was my brother Nicholas. So through God's mercy, I believe, and through the prayers of St. Herman, I believe I am one of those miracles of St. Herman of Alaska. My mother kept that icon print on her dresser. And in my first year of seminary, she passed. And so I grabbed that icon and brought it with me to seminary. And I have had it with me ever since. So I believe that that icon print from St. Herman that my mother had and the prayers to him are very holy. So continue praying to the saints. They're very important to us. And you know what? Here in the United States, we often think that the church is here, you know, that the church is here to give us something. Church is in this world to give me something because I'm most important. You know, when we're thinking about the 50th celebration of the Orthodox Church in America, it is not about us. This church was given to us as a gift from God. It is a blessing. It is a spiritual nourishment for us. We should never, ever take it lightly. And I believe the pandemic has made us realize that. I believe in this year of the pandemic, our church means a lot to us. We need God. We need the holy churches. We need his saints to help us along. So let's keep praying and working in the vineyard of Christ, helping it to grow. We all have a part, even in our own homes. If we're stuck in our homes and don't go very many places these days, we could always pray. I always tell people who are sitting there and, you know, are infirm in body and in a bed, they don't feel purposeful anymore, right? And so the complaint is, a lot of times I hear from the infirm and the people in the nursing homes, is what good am I anymore? Why am I still here? Because there is breath left in our lungs to pray. That's why we are here, to worship and glorify God. We are here to pray. So we could do that any way we are. And we bring the church, we emanate to the kingdom right before us, the saints become alive, the kingdom becomes alive, everything becomes alive around us when we give up our will and serve God. So may it be so for all of us. Christ is in our midst.
He's in our stomach.